Once you enter a meeting, there will be a pop-up at bottom left corner of your screen asking you to call via device audio. And if you tap on that, the headphone button will turn into a microphone button, and you will also get a message that you are using the device audio. And now you will be able to hear the teacher's voice, and the teacher will be able to hear your voice. However, after entering the meeting, if you don't tap on this call via device audio pop-up button and you tap somewhere else on the mobile screen, then this button disappears and the join audio button at bottom left corner of your mobile screen remains unchanged, and you will not be able to hear the voice of your teacher. In that case, what you can do, you can tap again on that join audio button and this call via device audio pop-up will reappear. You can tap that and then you will get a message that you are using the device audio and now you will be able to hear the voice of your teacher. Now you are in the Zoom meeting with audio and video. Now once you are in the meeting, you will see some control buttons at the bottom of your screen, and if you don't see these buttons anytime during the meeting, you can just tap on your mobile screen and these buttons will appear. Now, of all the buttons at the bottom of your mobile screen, the most important ones are the microphone button and the camera button. And at any time during the meeting, your microphone and camera may be on or off. So when the microphone or camera is on, it will have white color like the microphone here. And if they are off, then they will be red in color with a cross line. For example, the camera in this case. And to turn them on or off, you just have to tap them once. Now, if I tap on the video button, because I'm using the video in Zoom for the first time, Zoom will ask me for my permission to use camera for taking pictures and recording videos. And I tap on allow, then it will start using camera and you will see whatever is there in front of the mobile camera. And here it is actually using the selfie camera by default. And if you want, you can switch to rear camera by tapping on this button here at top left corner of your mobile screen. And now if I tap on the microphone button, it will turn off the microphone. And I can turn it on again by tapping the button once again. Now there, one more interesting feature in Zoom app. For example, if you have some doubt and you want to grab attention of your teacher, then there is a hand raise button in the Zoom app. And to get to that, you have to tap on the three buttons above this more, and it will open a pull-up menu, and there is an option to raise your hand. So you just tap on that and a tiny hand will appear at the bottom of your screen as well as your teacher's screen. So teacher will know that you have a doubt, so she may interact with you and solve your doubt. And once your doubt is solved, you can tap on the three dots above more and you will see that the raise hand button has changed into lower hand button. So you just have to tap on that and that will lower your hand. Now there is one more useful button and that is located at the top left corner of your mobile screen, and that is the speaker button. So you can tap on that button once to turn the speaker off or the speaker on. Now, once your class is over, you can leave the meeting by tapping on the leave button, which is located at the top right corner of your mobile screen. And when you tap on that button, a pop-up will appear asking you to confirm that you want to leave the meeting. And you can leave the meeting by tapping on the leave meeting button on that pop-up.